to you, well, once again, my life to Christ. Obviously, quite traditional in the church to pray like a sinner's prayer, but what you're presenting is baptism in water, repentance, baptism in water, baptism in the Spirit. How would you handle a situation where you have someone on the street who says, I want to give my life to Christ?
When we talk about this, I know it's the typical, I don't talk with him about it before, because I was in Sweden a short time ago, and there was a really fantastic church who have totally given up evangelizing. Why? Because they use like a paper where you ask people if you want to get saved, and then ask it into your heart. And they have seen like 300 people in 2 years do it. Mm-hmm. No people continue in church. And because of that, they lost the boldness to continue, because what is the result? The gospel is the power of salvation. The gospel can go in and change everything. And I believe in the power of the gospel, because I do what it says. I don't just ask this into your heart. I'm radical. And we have an evangelist in Denmark who's more known and going out. He has a simple gospel like this about you. He had the best thing for you. Just ask this and you have it. He had maybe 20,000 people who have forsaken Denmark. But to be honest, I believe I have more people who have continued in Christ than he had. Because out of those 300, 400 I have, there is 250 who's continuing, or 200, I don't know how it is. And this is, what do we want? Do we want radical believers? Do we have people who continue in it, or people don't? I also pray with people like you. Because when I pray with people, it's where I feel the heart is. Often I stop people and I'm not ready, have you moved, do you understand it? And it's not always easy to see, like the woman I prayed for today at the meeting was going to get baptized tomorrow. She said, I just want to get baptized, I just feel it. Well, I don't know anything, it's totally new and I'm ready. Are your heart beating fast? Yes it is, I want it. Okay, you're ready. Because it's the Holy Spirit who draws people. So what I do is often, when people want to get saved, I pray like a sinner's prayer. I don't say you are saved. I don't want to give the false hope, because baptism, water, and Holy Spirit is part of it. I just pray, and if they're ready, if they have moved, then they're really going to meet the Holy Spirit and meet God there. And then I said, this was the first step. Now we take the next step and the next step. So it's good to pray for people, but I encourage you to be careful in saying they are saved, because then we can get the idea that the gospel is not powerful anymore. Because where are the people who got saved? Can you follow me? Mm-hmm. So I know it's not against you, I know it's the way we think, the tradition. And I can see now, I'm very bold, it's so interesting. If you see in Denmark some of the people around the world, we see people get saved. They start with this radical. They have the same DNA. If you go to church, it's almost like you can say, do you know Tom Sumerov? Yes? We got saved through him. Oh, I felt there was something special. Not because me, but because they start with the radical repentance, baptism, water, and Holy Spirit. And when they got, you know, like when people are getting born in the physical life, if they have a bad birth, it's going to give problems later in life. If people get a good spiritual birth in the beginning, they're going to grow so much more later in life. So I believe it's important. But I pray a sinner's prayer with them, like what we call, I pray, don't say that's it, but I pray to feel, where are they? Do you want to? And then the next step.
Okay.
More questions? I just want to tell you one thing. You did it. Have you done it before?
No.
Do you like it?
Fantastic.
I love the English accent. I'm like crazy with it. What I encourage you to do, everybody, is that for us, what we did today, I it's a church, but it's also word, it's discipleship. I encourage you to make this not like only work and discipleship, but make this part of your life. And I think this is where it's strongest. I prayed for a woman who on the school where our kids was going last week. I was there to get my daughter and she said, oh Tom, can you come and pray for me? Her story is that 3 years ago we have a kid's birthday party with my daughter, and one of her friends came with bandages on her arm, and I saw that. But she was not, she was 9 years old, so I didn't want to pray. So when the mother came, hi, and what happened? Ah, she prayed. Okay, can we pray for her? Ask her. Okay, can I pray for her? Yes. And she got completely healed, and she took the she took the bandages off her arm, and she was healed. 1 year later, ding dong, they will open our door. Hello, can you pray for my daughter? She was having a problem with dahlias. Okay, I pray for she got healed. 1 year later, ding dong, she stand with her 2 kids. Hey, my daughter, he sick or he last night. My son here problem with, you know, under the foot where it's like small thing you have to cut up with the doctor.
No. No, it's that hook.
You no something you can freeze off. Yeah, wash, something like that. He had that. Can you pray for him? And I was like, he was like 7 years old. Okay, I didn't have more faith, but I prayed for him, and they went home. 2 days later, her husband was a bank chief. He didn't even call me. Can I come and meet you? Yes. And he came, he said in our living room, he said, I need to talk to you. You know what happened with my son? No. Oh, when he came home from you, he took his socks off and it was coming out of the socks. So he had fallen off the foot. I want to hear about God. And now I sat with him. And now the wife with him. So I can see it all started with a birthday party. Not out on the street. And today we only have 2 hours where we were looking for the sick people. But this is not 2 hour last night we have doing. We are doing 24/7. This is a lie. So now when you have your mind open, when you're standing in the queue in a shop, and hear somebody speaking, oh, I have so much pain in the back. Hi. No matter where you are, my testimony is very often when I go to shop, when I go home in a car, not when I'm looking, but just when I live my everyday life. So I encourage you to not make this an event. It's good to do it as an event to get started like you do and come together and continue training. And I encourage Adam and you to just meet again and go out again, because when you're many people, you can encourage each other. But don't make it an event. Make it a life. Everyday life, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. You like it?
Yes.
How many is not here tomorrow? Oh, there's a few people. But you're here tomorrow. Love you guys. It was good. Thank you for coming. And encourage you to continue. And remember the Bible school. I invite you everybody to Bible school. If you love some of the teaching here, that is the free Bible school. With all the teaching you can get. And you can translate it to Polish.
Yeah, I will.